I have to find a better way to keep the old witch quiet. Or I will stand behind the bars, or under my grave.
Benson? What do you need? Could you come out? Wait. You are already here? Yes, Edward. Come out now, or we don't have much time to hang up. Okay, I will be down then. Great. See you. Are you Benson? Yes. It's me, Benson Murphy. You look different. You look more cooler and handsomer. When did you change your look? Thanks, Edward. Calvin brought me to the hairdresser half an hour ago. Come on, let's go and pick up Phoebe. Great.
I am so happy that you are here now, daughter. How do you feel?
I feel better now. Thanks for bringing me out of the prison.
Let's go home. I will talk with you a little bit.
Sure.
Is Miss Butler at home?
No, she is still in the mental hospital. Why?
Miss Butler had to pay the rent today. Where is the money?
Oh, really? Could you wait here for a minute? I will bring you the money.
All right. 680 euros are to be paid.
All right. Wait here. I will be there in 1 minute.
Dear Joyce, it looks like you are getting better with your mental health. Keep doing it. Thank you. If you keep getting better, you may leave from here tomorrow. Thank you, God, for the great news. I can't wait to come home, where my son and husband are waiting for me. That's awesome. Now let's get started with the lesson.
Man, That was the best day we ever had, right?
Indeed. I won't forget that day. We should repeat it someday.
Look at that. Everything happened, we went through tough times, and we are still smiling.
Yeah, you're so right. I hope we will still smile, whatever it will happen.
Who knows if we three are still here or not?
Why are you saying that? Okay, we have been through tough times, but we are still living thanks to God.
Guys, did you forget it? This is the life. We don't know what will happen next. We cannot decide how our fate will be. It happens everything by itself.
I totally agree what he said right now. I met a new friend who also said things like that.
Your friend must have gotten through tough times too, right?
Yes, you're right.
Guys, whatever will happen, we will hold each other together. There is no give up. I tell you guys as your older brother, because we are a family.
We are not only friends. We are also a family.
Indeed. You two are my older brothers, and I am your little sister. I am afraid if I will lose one of you guys.
If I see you guys like that, I will be more happy than before.
Me too.
I'm used to living in black and white. I've always seen the black. I also managed to see the white. Why are you giggling?
You were talking like from the drama movies. Are you watching too much dramatic movies?
What is wrong? I am telling the truth. We have been through much things, tough things. I lost my mom, I got bullied in the school, I got pushed by Nicole and hit my head on the edge of the ground.
I had to repeat the class because of theater. I borrowed money from the moneylender, then I got stabbed, and I ended up in a coma.
And I lost my father, and got a stepfather. I got transferred into your class, and got bullied too. And lastly, I got beaten up by Calvin and his best friend.
Did you just say that you got beaten up by Calvin and his best friend? So those bastards who did it to you are Calvin. I understand now.
I can't believe it.
As I told you, daughter, do not bully Edward and Phoebe anymore, or something bad will happen, alright?
Alright, fine, I promise you.
Great, I will go now. Good night.
Good night. You are right. I love you too, but I can't be in relationship with you. Oh yeah, I will show it to you, you little bastard. Hello babe, where are you? Yes, I came out of the prison, now I want to see you. Great to see you now. I have to ask you something. How could you kiss that Phoebe bitch in front
of— I'm breaking up with you.
Are you fucking kidding me? Are you making a camera joke? Where the fuck are the cameras?
There are no cameras. I am serious right now.
You can't break up with me, understood? I am your girlfriend, show me that you are a man. So you are breaking up with me, and start a relationship with that Phoebe bitch, right?
I don't know what is wrong with you. How could you do this to her?
I didn't do something to her on purpose, Why does nobody understand me?
Nicole, I am so tired of your shitty behavior, alright? I can't be in relationship with someone who has anger problems. It's over.
No, Edward, it is not possible. I can't learn this stuff within 2 days for the exam. You know what? I can't study at all, because you are kidding me. You know why? Why? It's not possible that I was in coma for 2 weeks. I'm sure that I slept about 8 months.
Benson, but you already asked me after you woke up, which dates we have. And I explained you everything.
I want to die now.
Well, Benson, I will help you for studying before the first lesson begins. After that, you can go and die together, alright?
Alright, fine. Thanks.
Let's start now.
Raymond?
My fire princess? Good morning, my wife. How do you feel?
Good morning, my fire prince. I feel better now. And you?
I am viciously happy, because you will come back home. Finally, the fate wants us to live together and start to forget the past. Babe, now that you get released from here, where should we go first?
I have an idea. Now class, we have 10 minutes left before the lesson ends. I remind you guys to study for the biology test for tomorrow. Understood? Do you all know what topics the test will contain?
Yes, I know it.
Very well then. Good morning, the lesson ends in 10 minutes. I know, Miss Green, I'm sorry for my lateness. All right, please sit on your desk.
Everything is fine right now, no need to worry, Miss Harrington.
Thank you, Miss Brooke. What gender will my baby be?
Now let's see. Congratulations, Miss Harrington.
Raymond, do you want to know the gender of our baby?
What? It's known at the moment?
Yes.
Tell me now.
Raymond, it's a...
Wait, Joyce, don't tell me.
Why?
I want to know it after our baby's birth. You know, where the doctor comes with our baby and tells us, congratulations, it's a boy or a girl. I want it to happen like that.
Alright, fine. Let's do it like you want.
Thanks. Let's go to our home.
Phoebe, how is that possible that Nicole is suddenly back from prison? Don't tell me you withdrew your complaint.
Yes, I did it.
How could you be so stupid? I can't believe you.
Edward, I can't help it. I have a good heart, all right? I couldn't see her in prison, that's why I took her out of there.
Edward, just calm down. Don't you know that prison is a dangerous place? Of course she did that because of her conscience. It's not like she was threatened by someone, that she had to do this.
Yeah, right.
Alright, fine. I am so sorry for screaming you, Phoebe.
No problem.
Edward, let's go to the library. I have to study. Very well.
Kelvin, I have to talk with you about something. Would you follow me?
Yes, of course.
Nicole, it's good that you are healed up. Ask someone in this class if they could help you with the new topics, otherwise you can't success the biology test. Yes, Miss Green, I understand now. Perfect. Well then, see you tomorrow. I should look where Calvin is. I will show it to you, who you betrayed to.
Yes, Phoebe?
I know the truth, so I want you to explain me why.
Phoebe, what did I do?
Why did you beat up Edward?
Oh, that story, I understand now. Yes, I did it for Benson, because Edward ruined Benson's life.
Calvin, if you want me to have trust in you, then don't be a bastard to everyone.
Phoebe, but if someone I don't like makes one of my best friends' life difficult, of course I will show it to them.
If you still be like that, you can totally forget me. Edward is my best friend. He is like my older brother. If someone do something to him, they will find me in front of them, understood?
Understood.
Great. I hope you will stop abusing him. Bye.
There we are, babe. Let's go in.
Joyce is back home.
Welcome back home, babe.
Thank you, babe.
I have a surprise for you. You will dress up yourself for tonight, because we are going out.
All right, fine. I can't wait for your surprise.
Awesome. I will go to our room to change my clothes. See you, babe.
See you.
I don't have time for you, Nicole. Could you go, please? I want to eat something.
Go and choke on your own shit. I don't care anymore for you, understood?
What do you want?
I still can't believe you chose that ugly poor bitch. I won't give you any peace in this school, all right? It's over with us.
Phoebe is a friendly human. She has no negative personalities. She is not like you, so greedy, selfish, or maniac. If you were a completely different human, I would love you. But your character is not okay.
Calvin, you were so mean to me. I didn't do something bad to you.
Just give it up, girl. I don't care for you anymore. I am breaking up with you. And if you do something to Phoebe about that, you won't see me anymore.
Too much for me. Don't you understand me? The students trash everywhere and make the whole school dirty. It's enough.
But we still need you. I will try everything that they will stop making dirty everywhere, I promise you.
Forget that. You did it the last time, and nothing happened, because they are doing it on purpose. I will quit working here. Goodbye.
Welcome back home, daughter. Do you want something?
Yes. Pack your suitcase and go from here. I don't want you here anymore. This was your surprise, Raymond?
Yes, babe. My wish were always to go to a restaurant with you, and it came true.
You are so sweet. I also have a surprise for you.
What surprise? I am curious right now.
Let's just eat our dinner, then our dessert, and the final part will be your surprise.
I can't wait for it. Babe, tell me now. What did you think when you saw me the first time?
I fell deeply in love the first time I saw you. Your love, your personality made me feel beautiful and new. Thank you for giving me the taste of paradise. I love you so much.
That's so sweet of you, my fire princess. Let me say something too. You are the only one in the world whose love comes forward without a price.
Everyone, may I have your attention please? We have a pregnant woman who wants to reveal a baby gender.
Hello Dad, I am your baby boy. Nice to meet you.
Joyce, didn't I tell you not to tell me the gender of our baby?
No, I didn't.
What is your surprise then?
Our baby will be a baby boy.
Indeed, Ryan. Our baby is a boy.
Yes! Incredible! Come here, my love of my life.
Babe, I am so sorry. I thought you were revealing our baby's gender.
No, I won't do it, like you wanted.
But what is the surprise?
I allow you to drink alcohol after dessert for this night.
Oh, I understand now. Joyce, please don't be sad. I am so sorry. Come on, babe. Let's keep living normal like nothing happened, all right?
Of course we could meet tomorrow, dear Mason. Do you have an idea where we could meet?
Well, Edward, I don't really know. Do you have any idea?
Mason, how about we meet at the city park, and then go to my home?
All right, good idea, but what should we do there?
You can meet my mother.
Really? I don't know, I am really shy.
Don't be shy. My mother won't bite you.
All right, fine. See you tomorrow. I will go sleep.
Great. See you tomorrow. Good night.
Good night.
Who is that at this time? Hello. How may I help you?
Are you Edward?
Yes. Who are you? Do we know us each other?
I am Sandra West, Mason West's older twin sister. I have a word with you.
Oh, so you are his twin sister? I understand now. Nice to meet you.
Yeah, just go in. I have to talk with you.
Please, sit on the couch. What do you want to talk with me?
I won't talk too much, so I'm getting straight to the point.
Yes?
You should keep yourself away from Mason immediately.
What the hell are you talking about? Why should I do it?
I'm telling you for your own good. You don't know my brother. He got hurt and used by everyone and thrown out of their lives like a garbage bag. After that, he swore to do the same to other people when he meets new people.
You are lying. Okay, those things happened to him, but he won't do it like that. I believe that.
I won't lie, boy. I know him so good. He won't do any good to you.
Go out of here. I won't believe you what you say. I see the truth in his eyes.
You are doing wrong.
Shame of you. You are his twin sister. Nobody would do such bad things to their siblings.
Is that so, Edward? You will allow him to ruin your life.
There is the door. Good night, sleep well. I didn't see that horrible human in my whole life. Nicole number two.
Joyce, did you gain some weight?
So you say I am fat.
No, babe, I just joking, you know? You are incredible. And I love you so much that I want to make a second baby with you. I don't care, I want to make a big family.
Yeah, right.
Babe, why is everything dizzy suddenly? I can't even stand still.
You drank too much alcohol, that's why.
Really? I have an idea.
What idea, Raymond? I have to sleep now.
How about we drink a little bit more? Or have a little bit fun adventure in the kitchen?
Raymond, it's enough. Your drunkenness is really exhausting. Let's go sleep now.
I can't believe that Raymond drank too. My dad never drank a sip of alcohol in his entire life. Everyone says that alcohol makes you feel better, but I don't know.
Joyce, do you hear the music? It's a great music. You should dance with me too.
If I would know how is it to be drunk, I would understand him. But he is just exaggerate.
Babe, let's go to the kitchen and have a little bit fun there.
Later, Raymond. Later.
Hello. I want to tell you a secret.
What secret?
I killed Howard after he threw me out of the house. You know that?
Are you done with talking? I want to sleep now.
Wait, babe, I didn't finish telling you. He threw me out, then he wanted to stab me. And do you know what I did to him?
What did you do to him?
I grabbed the knife and stabbed him on his belly. And I paid homeless man to go to prison instead of me.
All right, Raymond. Great story. Let's go sleep. I am tired.
Good morning, babe.
Good morning, babe.
Man, those headache hurts like hell. I think I drank a little bit too much yesterday. Is that right?
A little bit? You drank the vodka like water. I warned you, but you didn't listen to me. You even told me yesterday something strange. What made me confuse?
What did I tell you? I can't remember right now.
You told me that you stabbed Howard on his belly and paid a homeless man to go to the prison instead of you.
Blah, blah, blah. She is talking like a robot. Big mouth, nothing behind.
Phoebe, did you say something? Why are you disturbing the lesson?
No, Miss Teacher, it's nothing.
Phoebe, I can't anymore. I have to go to the toilet right now.
KK.
Edward, what is wrong again? Stop talking with Phoebe.
May I go to the toilet? I really have to.
Fine. But don't take too much time. I have to ask you a question about this topic.
Now we are here, the last part. After the whole school is completely empty, you should clean the floors, and then the windows.
Mason? What are you doing here? Edward, you are a student in this school. Yes, but why are you dressed up like this? Why are you here?
Mr. Mason is our new janitor from now on. Come on, Mr. Mason, go to the locker's room and start cleaning the floors.